Hello and welcome back to the Xpert Eleven Road to Glory series, where last time we were unfortunately knocked out of the cup by Premium KS. So now we only have league games left between now and the end of the season. The only thing we can do now is develop this team for next season. Not that the league campaign isn't going well, of course, because we are currently 4th in the table on 9 points and level with Belfast City, only behind on goal difference. Our next game is against one of our relegation rivals from last season, Deportivo Celisol. However, there is a big difference between last season's Deportivo Celisol and this season's Deportivo Celisol. What is it? Let's find out. As you can see, Deportivo have completely rebuilt their squad with teenagers. There are 7 new players in their starting 11 and they're all 16 years old. This goes a long way to explain why they're in the relegation zone this season. Deportivo's team to face us is Azana in goal, a back four of Fogasha, Bruton, Mickey and Butarcia, a midfield of Asturias, O'Callaghan, Gregson, Bikiewicz and Breeze, and a front man of Zubenkov. As for our team, Sergei Kwiatkowski was sent off in the game against Premium KS, so he misses this match. 17-year-old Gilberto Manuel therefore comes in the usual starting 11 to replace him, while we've also made a change up front, we're putting Zubeldia over Mota. Our team for this game is Dihor in goal, a back four of Gorga, Santa Maria, Silka and Delia, a midfield of Canamassas, Manuel, Cayolla, Tilby and Roma, and a front man of Zubeldia. We now go live to the Salchicha Stadium for the match. The captains for this game are Pepon Mickey for Deportivo and Gavril Gorga for Knights. The referee is the frankly awful Hugh Kango, Deportivo in the green strip while Knights are in the red strip. Most of the attention in this division will be on the big match between Real El Madrid and Real Peeps, the top two. But anyway, the match gets underway now, and 5 minutes in, as you can see, it's looking like we're going to win this one fairly comfortably. Alvito Romero's curled shot is centimetres over the crossbar. We could win this fairly comfortably. Our team is the stronger one, despite the fact that the opponents have a good home advantage, but we are bossing the possession here. Alvito Romero's well-placed header. He scores! Alvito Roma scores his first competitive goal for Knights of Cydonia, assisted by Helen Tilby. 1-0 Knights. That is a great start for us. 27 minutes in, 1-0. But as you can see, Deportivo are making life a bit difficult here for us, so we're still restricting our chances. Aurelio Fogasha has been yellow carded for handball. 37 minutes in, 40 minutes in, and it's looking like the yes, that is the end of the first half. And in the first half, it is 1-0 to Knights of Cydonia, with 2 chances compared to their 0. We also have 57% possession compared to their 43%, so the second half will get underway, and I'm pretty sure it'll be more of the same. Can Deportivo restrict us to just the one chance? Can they even score a chance themselves? Oh wait, what's this? Republic of Mancunia are thrashing Belfast City, which means this win will take us to 3rd place in the league, just 3 points behind second place. Endira Zubelia's lob attempt. Here's the point where the post of the crossbar meet. Oh! Deportivo are being really resolute here to our advances. Zubelia's low shot again. That's wide by a clear margin. Adilson Azana is going to make things tough for us to score against him, and they are defending deep Deportivo here, which explains our massive amount of possession. We're going to break away here though. Endira Zubelia yet again. And he misses the goal by a meter. He's had so many chances. But Zubeldia just cannot find the back of the net today. He's had a good start to his career, but maybe that was spoken for. Penalty! There's a penalty to Knights of Cydonia in the 80th minute of the game. After hours of trying, Geo Dihor takes the penalty. The Sergio Kwiatkowski is gone and it scores! Geo Dihor for Knights of Cydonia gets Adilson Azana, 2-0. 83 minutes gone, we've got another chance here with Sergio Canamassas, who's been a star for us so far, and he scores as well. The floodgates have opened. 2 goals in 3 minutes after just 1 goal in 80, and it's 3-0 to us now. And in the 87th minute, we have another chance here. Alvito Romero again, and he scores again. What a game this is for the youngsters. Alvito Romero from Gilberto Manuel's pass, he rifled it into the back of the net. What a star this guy's going to be. 19 minutes in, Zubeldia again, can he score to add to it? Nope. Adilson Azana has forced Zubeldia's attempts, and that looks to be that. That is the end of the game, and it is 4-0 to Knights of Cydonia, the final score. The two captains of the man of the match, Pepo Mickey for Deportivo and Gavril Gorga for Knights of Cydonia. We dominated the chances, restricting Deportivo to zero chances, and that is a pretty easy win for us. So, why did Deportivo do so badly? Well, even though they do have a few experienced players, a team consisting entirely of youths isn't going to do that well even if they do have a large home advantage factor. And so, their defending deep restricted our chances, but ultimately, they were never going to create any against us, which led us to a very easy win. And that's all I can say, really. So, it's time to see the team of the week, although I can guess which two teams might be dominating it. Wow, it's actually quite a mixed team of the week here, with Elvis Grussell of Red FC in goal, a back four of Gavril Gorga, Knights of Cydonia, Arrigo Galente, Real Peeps, Patak Evra, Real El Madrid, and Mimo Molyo, Real El Madrid. Midfield, Declan Frampton, Real Peeps, Dirk Dilly, Real El Madrid, Anka Gerdstuk, Republic of Mancunia, and Hubert Terrien, Republic of Mancunia, who was playing in midfield for this game. Both Gerdstuk and Terrien are defenders by trade. And a front two of Runa Sodden, Belfast City, and David David, Real El Madrid. Manager of the round is the Peeps for his victory over title rivals Real El Madrid, which puts him in a great position in the top of the table. That Peeps victory puts them on 18 points at the top of this division, with Real El Madrid in second place on 15 points. We are now in third place on 12 points after our fourth straight win in the league, which goes above Belfast City, who suffered a shock defeat to Republic of Mancunia. Belfast City are now in fifth place, just above the relegation zone, although they do have a 6-point gap between them and sixth place Red FC. Nevertheless, I suspect our winning run is about to come to an end as we face the unbeaten league leaders Real Peeps in our next game in the first of the double headers as we head to the halfway point of the season. See you guys then!